अमृतार्थकरणनिशिनिशयाना नाना मनोरथ धिया क्षण भग्न निद्रा दैव अहतार्थ रचना ऋषयो योपि देवा युष्माद् प्रसंग विमुखा यो संसरन्ति युष्माद् प्रसंग विमुखा यह संसरन्ति अहम् अप्तितार्थकरणनिशिनिशयाना नाना मनोरथ धिया क्षण भग्न निद्रा दैव अहतार्थ रचना ऋषयो योपि देवा युष्माद् प्रसंग विमुखा यह संसरन्ति युष्माद् प्रसंग विमुखा यह संसरन्ति गौड़ीय गोष्ठीपति श्री शिल भक्ति सिद्धांत सरस्वती गोस्वामी ठाकुर प्रभुपाद जगद्गुरु टोल्ड दैट मेटेरियल पीपल दिस मेटेरियल वर्ल्ड इज सो एब्जॉर्बिंगली बिजी विथ मेटेरियल थिंग दैट देर इज नो स्कोप दैट दे कैन गेट एनी चांस टू थिंक अबाउट दिस इटर्नल वर्ल्ड गौड़ीय गोष्ठीपति श्रील भक्ति सिद्धांत सरस्वती गोस्वामी ठाकुर जगद्गुरु बहुपाठो दिस मेटेरियल वर्ल्ड इज सो बिजी विथ मेटेरियल थिंग्स दैट दे आर नॉट गोइंग टू गेट एनी चांस टू अंडरस्टैंड अबाउट दैट इटर्नल वर्ल्ड व्हाट टू डू इट इज जस्ट नेक्स्ट टू इम्पॉसिबल टू मेक देम अंडरस्टैंड स्टिल वी आर ट्राइंग Actually, point is that those material people, they are busy with material enjoyment. They are, even in the night time, they are watching some dirty, very bad dream. And they become nervous. This way, all the time, they are busy with material things. So somehow, Supreme Lord, Bhagavan, Sri Krishna, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, they are trying to arrange through Shastra or Guru Vaishnava, they are Bhagavan trying to arrange something for them so that somehow they can understand someday. That is why we find. And also I told, without Bhagavad Avesh, one cannot act as an acharya. Without Bhagavad Avesh, one cannot speak actual Harikatha. Try to understand. Bhagavad Avesh means is always absorbingly thinking about that eternal world, not material things. Always, non-stop. If he is not not going to think about the eternal world all the time, it is impossible for him to act as an acharya. So, Bhagavad Avesh, Prabhupada used to say, without Bhagavad Avesh, nobody can act as an acharya, nobody can speak a prakita harikatha, not possible. And also, sadhu shastra rupe, Shastra, Sadhu, all, you know, Shastra and Sadhu, they all Bhagavan sending to help us. That is the only reason. And who can understand there is eternal world? Without Satsanga, nobody can realize. Without Satsanga, nobody can realize. Not possible. So satsanga is a must. And Bhagavan Supreme Lord, He Himself also, Bhagavan Supreme Lord, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu also going to show us about this procedure of satsanga. So He is going here and there to get satsanga all the time. Raya Ramananda Sarvadamadar, I can discuss about Nilachale Mahaprabhu, I mean the total Gambhira Leela, what was Gambhira Leela, how Bhagavan Sri Krishna Chaitanya doing, I can discuss this point someday. So now point is that this Shastra is vast. Ananta Param Kilasastra Sabdam. Nigam Shastra is Bipul, vision vast. Some part going to discuss about Dharma, some part about Karma, some part going to discuss about Sankhya Yoga, some part Bhagavad Bhakti, different. So, for different kind of people, Bhagavan going to arrange this thing. And after that, some going to take decision that karma is the final thing, karma yoga. Some going to think, take decision, you know, karma yoga, dhyan yoga, gyan yoga, sankhya yoga, this way. And some going to take decision, avet brahmavad. Avet means impersonal brahma. They think it is final. This way, after Bhagavan Sri Krishna gone, there was so much problem here in this earth. After that again Chaitanya Mahaprabhu coming, after that there was darkness. Again, Saragoswami and, you know, after Saragoswami and Jiva Goswami Pad, everybody gone. After that we get some Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Prabhupada. Then now we are going to get some facility. In between, there is big problem. Why this kind of advice given in Gita? Sometime we see, after discussing Karma Yoga, saying it is final, it is nice. To grow their nishtha according to their right, to grow their nishtha, Bhagavan arranging this way. Some busy with Karma Yoga, some with Gyan Yoga, this way they are busy. Someday they can go up, they can understand what is the final thing, if their luck is good. Totally, I already told that final advice of Srimad Bhagavad Gita is to show us the way of Saranagati, final Bhakti Yoga. It is the final. Those who are reading Gita, we can divide them into two parts. One is with those who are busy with external meaning and those who are busy with internal meaning. Internal meaning, those who are busy with external meaning, they cannot understand the actual thing. And those who are busy with internal meaning, under the guidance of Guru Vaishnava, they can realize everything. They can. So, yesterday I was discussing that somebody going to conclude that according to guna evam karma, there is a final advice of Krishna to engage Arjuna in fighting, yuddha. So, Chaturvarna Maya system, Guna Karma Vibhagasaha. So according to that, they think that it was the final objective of Krishna to engage Arjuna into fighting according to his nature, Kshatriya. Somebody can say, Param Vaishnava, who is a Param Vaishnava Arjuna, Param Vaishnava Arjuna, why we can say he is only Kshatriya? Because he is Param Vaishnava. Brahma, he is not with Brahma, Brahma Sabha, Brahman Sabha, not there. Why Arjuna is not with Brahma Sabha? Whereas we know Arjuna is Param Vaishnava, Yudhishthira is Param Vaishnava. Now question is that, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, to do this kind of leela, actually Arjuna eternally present, but still to do this kind of leela, Bhagavan Sri Krishna arrange it, And Arjuna was also bound to accept this Kshatriya Swabhav. The nature of Kshatriya coming at present inside Arjuna, eternally actually Shuddha Bhav is there. That is why, you know, to teach us gradually, so Bhagavan going to give us advice this way, that's why they are busy. Now actually I told you, those who are actually like to go up in their Hari Bhajan, so if they are enjoying the kripa of pure Guru Vaishnava, then their actual kripa of Guru Vaishnava, then they need not follow this gradual procedure of promotion. But those who are not enjoying full kripa, for them gradually they will have to go up according to their guna karma. According to that they will have to go up. And those who are actually nitya sannyasi. Nitya sannyasi means those who are having no fighting with anybody, their mind is equipoised. They are never going to fight with anybody, nothing. So, 2-3 days ago I told you, Geyoho sa nitya sannyasi yo na deshti na kankhati. Who has no desire, no expectation, no desire, and no fighting with anybody. He is pure balanced, his heart. So, geyoho sa nitya sannyasi yo na deshti na kankhati, nirdondo hi mahabhavo sukham bandhyat pramuchyate. He is very easily, he can cut his material bondage. He can easily cut. So, not that Grihastha Bhakta, those who are staying in, leading their family life, they cannot come out successful, not that. It depends upon their condition. What condition is there with them? So, you see, Vidya vinaya sampanne brahmanne govi hastini suni chaiva sapyake cha panditaha samadarshana. An actual pandit who is going to have balanced darshan everywhere. Vidya vinaya sampanne brahmanne govi hastini suni chaiva sapyake cha panditaha samadarshana. He is always samadarshan. He is with samadarshan. Now, though this is the condition of Pandit, actual Pandit, and those who are original sannyasi, I already told that those who are already eternally sannyasi, they are sannyasi, nitya sannyasi, they have no problem in their life, they are balanced. Ihaiva toirijitam jesam sammesthitam manah. Ihaiva toirjitaha, ihaiva toirjitaha sargo jesam sammesthitam manah. In this life, you are leading your life, na? In this life itself, you can conquer maya. Ihaiva toirjitaha sargo jesam sammesthitam manah. Nirdosham hi samam brahmo tasmat brahmani te sthitaha. Those who are totally balanced minded, equipoised, and in this life, when they are leading their life itself, they conquer maya. They are out of the influence of the three modes of nature. Then they can get in connection with Brahma Vastu. Because Brahma Vastu with contaminated condition, you cannot get in connection with Brahma Vastu. Nirdosham hi samam brahmo tasmat brahmani te sthitaha. So they can automatically get chance to do that. And what is their symptom? In that case, in that condition, they are not going to laugh when they are going to get something which is favorable to them. Very nice thing they are getting. So they are laughing. And when they are going to get some opposite, then they are crying. This is not a condition. So, Bhagavan Sri Krishna was speaking to Arjuna, Na prahishyat priyam prapa. Na prahishyat priyam prapo, no dijet prapo cha priyam. Sthira buddhi rasam mudho, brahmavid brahmani sthitaha. Na prahishyat, he is not going to enjoy when getting something good. You know, good means favorable. And he is not going to cry, not going to repent when he is going to get some opposite. Is the condition balanced minded? Is the condition. So, but naturally, those who are bonded soul, those who are, they are going to follow some procedure through which they like to arrange their dharma, artha, kam, moksha. That is their target. Dharma, artha, kam, moksha, even dharma, they have no clear idea, they have no clear conception about what is dharma. I already explained yesterday. Also, I explained yesterday that Sava Ipangsam Paro Dharmo Yato Bhakti Radhakshaje Ahetiki Apratihata Yatma Su Prasidati. So, this way actually, somebody going to do some jagya, somebody going to do different kind of thing they are following. But in Bhagavad Gita, in Mundaka Upanishad, we find Plavahi ete adrida jagya rupa ashtodashokto mavaram jesu karma etat sreyo je ovinananti muda jara mirtum te puno revapi yanti. Those who are going to depend upon jagya. Jagya means there's fire sacrifice they are doing. In Kalikal, especially this without nam jagya, Bhagavat katha is the topmost procedure of bhajan. Plava means boat with the help of which you like to cross this material ocean. Those who are foolish, they like to take the help of jagya, this, that. But this boat is unstable because for jagya you need ritik. Ritik means those who are doing jagya. Some reciting Veda hymns, some going to put ghee, somebody going to rectify if there is any mistake. 16 different, you know, ritik, those were arranging. And jajman means who is going to arrange the jagya. They are all busy and together with that, the wife of the jajman who is arranging jagya. All in totals, 18, they are trying. But to cross this material ocean, this is unstable. We cannot believe. Those who are going to believe on this kind of unstable procedure of bhajan, surely they are going to take birth again. They are going to put themselves in the cycle of death and birth. This way they can go on. Any action you are doing has some result. Every action what you are doing, karma, any action, whatever do you, suppose karma matra, any action has some result. If you are going to take food, has some result, you are going to give nourishment to your body. If you are going to do marriage, then ultimate result is to get some baby. This way, each and every action has its some result. And also I told you akarma, bikarma, kukarma, everything I discussed before. Now actually Sriman Mahaprabhu by the advice of Rai Ramanda going to meet with by the advice of Sarvam Vartaja, you are going to meet with Rai Ramananda to get satsanga. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu going to South India for his different pilgrimage, he is going to, and by the advice of Sarvam Vartaja, he is going to meet with Rai Ramananda there because he liked to get satsanga. And in course of satsanga, Mahaprabhu wanted to unveil all the mystery of bhajan, how to do from the beginning to the end, ultimate goal. What is the topmost, you know, saddha sadhan tattva, saddha sadhan tattva, what is the topmost goal? Mahaprabhu wanted to show to us. That is why Mahaprabhu meet with Rai Ramananda there. So we can enter into this matter today. So Rai Mahajai, actually, when meeting with Bhagavan Sri Krishna Chaitanya, he was sitting under a tree there, under a banyan tree. Rai Mahajai coming with full, you know, all Brahman there following him, Karmakandi Brahman, and with Vedic hymns and musical instrument playing, he is coming to, why? To take bath in Ganga. Internally, he is totally Raganuga Bhakta. Internally, he is totally in absorbing condition of Radha Dasya. But still, externally, he is going to follow this kind of procedure, rules, and all, so that people can follow their own procedure. They can also, that they cannot break their system, Shadharma, they can do accordingly. So now, when Rai Ramananda coming with all Brahman, everything, everybody, then he could see that Mahaprabhu sitting under a banyan tree. Then after watching, he is going to pay dandavat to him. And after paying dandavat, he is, you know, going to, you know, ask something to Mahaprabhu, asking, "Are you Rai Ramananda?" Then Rai Ramananda Mahasaya speaking, "Yes, you are right. I am that Shudra Rai Ramananda. I am Shudra Rai Ramananda." This way, because the gateway of bhajan, entrance, is Trinada Vishwanichana, humbleness. So Rai Mahasaya naturally having, I already told those who are having in the way of Radha Anugatta, Radha Dasya, to Trinada Vishwanich Bhav is quite natural with them. So all Brahman Vaishnav, they are waiting and Mahaprabhu paying. Now Mahaprabhu, you know, speaking, Mahaprabhu actually speaking that, "Are you Ramananda?" Rai Ramananda was, "Yes, I am Shudra, that Ramananda." Then Rai Mahasaya speaking that those devotees, they are not actually devotees, they are Brahman. They are watching you. Rai Mahasaya speaking, "Prabhu, what is the excellency? They never know what is bhakti, nothing. They are going to watch you, and by your darshan, they are also going to change their heart. Their heart going to melt. In your presence, when they are going to watch you, those who are coming with me, those who are all coming with me, they are going to, they are going to see you, but they change their heart. What is the excellency? They never do Harinam in their life. What is this? It is a there is the proverb, excellency. So I think you are Supreme Lord." Rai Mahasaya is speaking, "I think you are actually Supreme Lord. So your great influence, because when Rai Mahasaya was watching Mahaprabhu, he could see thousands of suns, sun god at a time, so tejomai, so powerful. Mahaprabhu just speaking opposite. "Actually, you are Bhagavata Tama. So your prem is one kind of, treasure that is there. So in your presence, they are going to, get that kind of Baba. So what to speak about them? Even I am Mayavadi Sannyasi. I am Mayavadi Sannyasi. You know, I don't understand Prem Bhakti, nothing. I understand nothing. Ado. So, I don't understand about the glories of, you know, devotees. You know, but still, today, I am feeling something. Mahaprabhu speaking, in your presence, in front of you, when you meet me, I am feeling something extraordinary, unusual. So I think you are Mahabhagavat. Mahabhagavat, you are. So, Mahaprabhu speaking this way, and Mahaprabhu is a total source of Trinadapi. Total source of Inadapi. Arayanamanda is the embodiment of Trinadapi, Guru Varga, you know. Now, Mahaprabhu speaking, to rectify me, to purify me, Sarvam Vata Jajus sending me to you. Now I can realize, because in front of you I am going to feel, get some feeling, extraordinary feeling. So I think, Sarvam Vata Jajus, out of his own love for me, he is giving advice me to go and meet you. So to rectify me. That is why he is going to send me, so I am today successful, I come and meet you so easily. So in Chaitanya Charitamrita it is written, Onner ki katha ami mayavadi sannyasi, ami ho tomas parse krishna preme bhashi. Ei jani kothin mor hridaye shodhite, sarvabhoma kohilen tomare milite. In Chaitanya Charitamrita it is written, in Rayadamana Sangbad, what to speak about all other people? I am myself one Mayavadi Sannyasi. I also going to get, you know, Krishna Prema. I am floating in the ocean of Prema. So it's your excellency. It is your, by your association, I am getting that kind of feeling. So that is why now I can realize why Sarvabhauma was so merciful. He wanted to give me advice to meet you now. So to rectify me. After that, Raya Ramananda started watching the beautiful lotus mouth of Mahaprabhu, absorbingly. Raya Ramananda continuously, non-stop, without any, you know, continuously, Raya Ramananda watching at Mahaprabhu to drink the nectarian, you know, bhava of Mahaprabhu. So Trinadapi Sunich bhav is a original bhav. Trinadapi bhav, without Trinadapi bhav, nobody can enter into this bhajan field. So, Raya Mahasaya also showing this, and Mahaprabhu also showing this. Mahaprabhu speaking, I don't understand about Sadhu Sadhana Tattva, nothing. So, could you please come and I like to hear something from you. Krishna Katha. I like to hear some Krishna Katha from you. So, I have some desire. So, now you are busy, you are going away. So, I keep hope that I can get your darshan again. And in the meantime, sometime they are discussing in the meantime, one Brahman, pure Brahman coming by the desire of Mahaprabhu, Supreme Lord. One Brahman in the meantime coming and inviting Mahaprabhu to take prasadam in his house. So Mahaprabhu was bound to go. Before that, Raya Mahasaya speaking just opposite. It is a play. It is a nice game actually. You know, he is speaking this way. Raya Mahasaya speaking Jai Sarva Mortijajyo is very merciful to me. That's why he is going to send you to, you know, going to send you to me to rectify me. I am Shudra Adham. Very low condition. So that is why I understand Sarva Mortijajyo is going to send you to me. Anyway, in the meantime, one Brahman came and invite him, Mahaprabhu, and Mahaprabhu was invited and gone. And in the meantime, Rayamandu, after taking bath in Godavari, he also gone there. So this way actually, Ananta Lilamai Hari, Paratvara Akhileshwar Bhagavan, when, why doing this kind of lila? That is a very mystery. When Mahaprabhu doing this, what kind of lila, who can say? Now actually, we know Rai Mahasaya is Visakha Sakhi and Sarup Damodar Lalita Devi, Lalita Sakhi. We can discuss all about Nilachale Mahaprabhu and all the lila vilas, they are inside Gambhira Mandir. And why I told that if you like to see Vrindavan, you will have to go to Gambhira Mandir to understand the Bhava of Vrindavan. If you like to get entry into Vrindavan actually, then you will have to. I can explain all this thing after, not now. Nay Bhagavan, actually Bhagavan Gaur Sundar wanted to hear something from Rai Ramananda. I know, because if Mahaprabhu himself going to speak all about this Tattva Vigyan, then like Gita, when Bhagavan seeks everything, Sri Krishna giving all Tattva Vigyan to us, and common people misunderstand him, Madhijaji, Mangramas, Guru, etc., then they are, you know, speaking, everybody is speaking, worship me, come to me, worship me, this, that, they are in confusion, they don't understand. So when Supreme Lord going to directly speaking, you worship me, you know, whatever you are going to do, everything, jag, jagya, dan, tapasa, whatever, you give to me. Then people misunderstand. That is why Mahaprabhu now going to depend upon Rai Mahasaya. He is giving kippa to Rai Mahasaya. With the help of Rai Mahasaya, in discourse, question and answer. The now Mahaprabhu, in the evening time when Rai Mahasaya coming and meeting going to meet with Mahaprabhu, then they are sitting whole night. They are discussing the Sadda Sadhana Tattva, everything in details. So Mahaprabhu this time wanted to put question in front of Rai Mahasaya and wanted to hear all answer from him, so that common people they can get this kind of you know, clear conception that Mahaprabhu not directly speaking, but actually Mahaprabhu speaking inside Rai Ramananda. Rai Mahasaya already speaking. I am also speaking that inside me you are speaking, really so. So now Mahaprabhu is going to put question and he is not going to speak anything, only question, not, you know. Srota, he wanted to get satsanga, in course of satsanga, Mahaprabhu like to clear all these things. Saddha-sadhan-tattva-sar, totally the final thing of all Saddha-sadhan-tattva is Bimal Krishna Prem, Ahituki Krishna Bhakti. I already told yesterday, the final outcome of your Saddha-sadhan-tattva is Bimal Krishna Prem, Ahituki Krishna Bhakti, without any reason, without any, ahituki mani, without, there is no reason for why you are going to so. Naturally, quite natural. Ahituki Krishna Bhakti, what is available in only Brajavasi, inside Brajavasi this kind of bhakti is available. Brajaprem, nobody can give, not even Narayan, nobody can give. That's why in Chaitanya Charitamrita it is written, Ami bina Brajaprem dite nari dite nahi shakti. Except me, nobody can give this Krishna Prema. Krishna Prema for Kita. Nobody can give Krishna Prema. Only Krishna can give. Only Krishna can give Krishna Prema. That's why Narayan cannot give Krishna Prema, Vishnu. Nobody can give Krishna Prema. Only Ami bina Krishna Prem, Braja Prem. Ami bina Braja Prem dita nahi shakti. Which is exclusive Prema. Which is just we can find inside Brajadham. Braja Prema means those Brajavasis, they are showing Prema, that is called Braja Prema. It's called Braja Prema. In Bhagavad Gita, Bhagavan going to speak to Arjuna, Jai Jathamang Prapadante Tang Sasiva Bhajamyam. Who is going to do bhajan? You know, I can pay him. According to their bhajan mode, I can pay them. Jai yathamang prapadyante tang sasiva bhajamyaham. I can pay. This is the usual rule. But inside Vrindavan, that is not applicable. Inside Vrindavan, it is not applicable because the tremendous love of Brajavasis for Krishna and the tremendous love of Krishna for Brajavasi exclusive thing. Brajavasi Savabhik Prem, Savabhik Prem, Krishner Savabhik Prem, Brajavasi Pati. Krishna having natural, spontaneous love and attraction for Brajavasis. Brajavasi Savabhik Prem, Krishna Prati. And Krishna Ro Savabhik Prati, Brajavasi Pati. So it's automatic. Mutual. So only inside Vrindavan we can see that the commitment of Krishna is failure. Only inside Vrindavan we can find the commitment of Krishna is totally failure. And what to speak about those gopikas, those who are busy with exclusive seva, body, speech and mind, everything they are using for Krishna seva. Everything they are using for Krishna Seva, everything. So, for them, Bhagavan speaking, na parayaham niravadda sangyuyam, jama avajano durjano kriho singhala, sangbrishya tadava patiyatu sadhuna. Na parayaham niravadda sangyuyam. The kind of seva you have, the kind of love you have shown to me, it is exclusive. I cannot even imagine. So, na pare aham niravadda sangyujam. Yama avajano durjana griho singhala sangbrishya tadva pratiyatu sadhuna. You are all going to break all the bond, you know, there is some rules and regulation in the society. You are going to break every rapture, all you break, and you are going to do your seva. No rules and regulation can stand. When you can understand Braja Prem, when you can grow that kind of love, then you can find the social system, Varnasham, Dharma, all social system, all one kind of bondage to you. All, you know, all bondage to you. And nothing, you know. So when you can realize, when you can follow Brajavasis, those Brajavasis, one of such Brajavasis, according to your mind, what kind of bhava you are having, if you have, then you can bisinkalattamayatin lokavidisthitihi. Prabhudananda Saraswati was speaking, that when you are getting that kind of tremendous prema, exclusive prema, then you are bound to speak there's a social, there's regulation, rules and regulation, all social system, all, you know, big problem. We don't need. Bishinkalatamayate nalokobeda sitihi. Bishinkalatamayate, all bishinkalatamayate. Then you can say, all disturbance. I don't need. But in preliminary stage, people have to follow all varnasam dharma rules and regulation of the society, everything. But finally, you will have to, you can automatically feel that visinkalatamayate nalokobeda sitihi, all rules and regulations, everything, one kind of problem for me. Because you are tremendous attraction for Krishna Seva, you are busy with Krishna Seva, the social system is one kind of impediment to you. So you cannot deal, you cannot do. So now Mahaprabhu going to sit with Raya Mahasaya. And if Mahaprabhu is speaking his own lecture, if Mahaprabhu is going to speak all tattva-vigyan and everything, then somebody can speak that is one, this is one sampradayik, some sectarian attitude. Somebody can claim. But that is why Mahaprabhu putting question and Raya Mahasaya going to give answer. But Mahaprabhu sitting inside the heart of Raya Mahasaya. And otherwise, how it is possible when today is big disturbance. I am not feeling energy. There's too much internet problem. I cannot. So I'm feeling trouble. Every fraction of second. So you see, excuse me. Now Mahaprabhu sitting in front of Raya Mahasaya, Mahaprabhu is coming to meet with Mahaprabhu in that house exclusively, and they're sitting and Mahaprabhu going to discuss, and Mahaprabhu going to put question in front of Raya. I like to hear Sadhya Sadhana Tattva. Sadhya Tattva Sarup Ki. What is the Sarup of Sadhya Tattva? When Mahaprabhu going to put question, what is the sarup of Sadhya Tattva? So what is the written there in Chaitanya Charitamrita? Mahaprabhu speaking, Pado Slok Shadhyan Ninnoy. I like to understand the sarup of Sadhya. So you please go on reading and speaking. Rai Kahe Rai Maas, are you going to speak? Shadharma Acharani Vishnu Bhakti. What is written in Chaitanya Charitamrita? First I am going to read that thing, Bengali. Shadharma Acharani Vishnu Bhakti. I am also going to speak from the very beginning. So that we can have the scope to understand right from the beginning. Gradually we can go up. That's why Ramasan starting from just from the beginning. Beginning for them, those who are in the area of Vedic culture. Those who are out of Vedic culture, for them, first of all, they will have to come then. Because I already told, is Bharat Varsha, India, is a place of Dharma Khetra. Where only and only in India, so long it was possible to apply is Varnasam Dharma, scientific way. But at present it is not possible, all disturbance also taking place. That's why it is Dharma Khetra Kurukhetra. And it is Dharma Khetra, India, Bharat Varsha. And why it is Dharma Khetra? But here you can get the scope to follow Dharma. You have to, Dharma, totally. And Bhagavad Dharma is the final, actually. So Vedic culture, according to Vedic culture, you can have some scope to follow. Varnasam, Dharma, everything you can follow in properly. At present, by the mercy of Gauranga Mahaprabhu, it is spreading all over the world. That is mercy, causeless mercy. So Prabhu speaking, try to speak about the sarup of Sadhya, Sadhya Tattva. Pado Srok Sadhyan Ninnoy. Rayamas is speaking, starting from Shadharma Acharane Vishnu Bhakti Hai. Sadharma acharane Vishnu bhakti. What is sadharma? I am speaking for 5 days continuously about, you know. Sadharma nidanam seho paradharma bhayabaho. I already told. Se adhikari janishtaha sa gunaha parikirtitha. That I already told. Sadharma means, according to varna among ashram, you have to follow varna among ashram according to your quality. According to your quality. So, according to your nature. So, you have to. So, sadharma, it is the sadharma, it is the sadharma of Arjuna, is to fight. Sadharma, varnasam, dharma, everything is applicable up to that point. Up to which point? Mane, when you are going to realize that Bhagavad Tattva Vigyan, totally you are getting Krishna Prema, Bhagavad Dharma, then not. But preliminary stage you will have to follow everything. So the general conception of sadharma is according to his previous sanskar, according to his taste, you know, condition, he is going to do something that is called sadharma. Gun evang karma. Gun, nature. According to nature, they are going to do, and karma, going to do. Sadhana dara, what we can. Now, first question is there. What do you mean sadhana? What do you mean by sadhana? Sadhana is a general term. Sadhana is a general term. It means you are going to take some step, you are going to do something through which you have some target to get something. Suppose you like to cook something. So before cooking, you will have to arrange everything. All you have to sabji amanna, everything you will have to piece, everything you can arrange everything. After that cooking done, and after cooking you are getting bhoga. So sadhan means the procedure you are following through which you keep hope to get something. That is called sadhan. It is general term. So when people, they are following their life, varnasam dharma, by their, you know, sadharma acharan, through which surely they are going to expect something. So sadhanadya, they are expecting something. That saddhavastu, they have their target to get that thing, that is called prayojan tattva, ultimate, what they want to get. That is called prayojan tattva. And in our bhajan, Bhagavad Dharma Vigyan, Bhagavad Tattva Vigyan, when we are going to follow Bhagavad Dharma, our final goal is to get Krishna Prema. It is our target. So long as, though, you know, this population, this human being, they cannot understand about this Bhagavad Tattva Vigyan, they cannot understand about Bhagavad Dharma, till then, they will have to follow this gradual procedure. According their varnasam dharma is very good for them, which can put them in some rules and regulations system, otherwise total system can break down. Varnasam dharma is good. Otherwise, the number of sinful activities can increase. So all system can break down. So when somebody going to do something, they have some objective, why they are going to do this thing, the objective must be there, target. And if you think very deeply, what is the original reason for that, you can find they are going to arrange sukh, bliss and ananda. Everybody doing something, but the final thing is to get ananda, enjoy, sukh, ananda. Bliss means this material bliss. I'm not going to use transcendental bliss, is not a matter of joke. So everybody doing, anybody doing anything, ultimate goal is that to get in a sukh. Sukh means bliss or enjoyment, ananda. That is the, because they are all jiva, originally their sarup is same, because Bhagavan is Satchidananda, Satchid Anandamaya. So naturally, Mamaivamsa Jiva Lope Jiva Bhuto Sanatanaha. Mamaivamsa, my, you know, those jiva coming from me, they are my part. Part means not that Bhagavat Tattva, Bhagavan, Bhagavat Tattva divided into pieces, not that. Bhagavan not divide, a Shakti. Because the any part of Bhagavan, any part of Bhagavan is full, Purna Tattva. Any part of Purna Tattva is also Purna. Follow. You can remember someday, long ago I told you, even one dust particle from Vaikuntha is more valuable than this material world, infinity material world. Why I told you? Because the infinity material world has no value, it is a negative world. Even one dust particle from that transcendental world, Golok Vaikuntha, is Purna Vastu. And Purna Vastu is Purna. And Purnasya Purnamadayo Purnameva Avasishvati. We learned from Upanishad that any Purna Vastu, from Purna Vastu I am going to take, you know, something, it is also Purna. So I cannot, you know, I cannot think that way. I cannot think that way that Mamaivamsa means it is the particle, it is the part of Bhagavan, not that. If they are the part of Bhagavan, they are also Purna Vasu, there cannot be any dissatisfaction, nothing can be there, no problem. But Jivatma is a particle, fifth particle. Just like life. In Vedanta it is written, Gunat Alagbat. Gunat Alagbat. Qualitatively it is just like light particle. Also finally, when I can discuss Mayavad and Vedanta Tattva, then I can prove, finally I can prove, that this Jivatma, Anushabda, their particles, they are like sound particle. Though it is written in Vedanta, Gunat Alagbat, but finally you can see that they are just like, I can prove it, just like sound particle. Like light particle it is living, still I can show you. Finally, I can prove. So, this world also, the NASA scientists, they are bound to draw some conclusion from where they are speaking. This world is created from a low moan of sound, very sweet sound, frequency. From there the whole world created. This is going to support our Shastra also. Because we know Bhagavan playing on flutes, very sweet, Bhangshit Dhani, you know, Eko Aham Bahuswam, from their creation taking place. Om Iti Ekaksharam Brahma Mantra. From there it is the Bija. It is the original source of his creation. Brahma Gayatri. And when you are reciting Brahma Gayatri, you can feel something. You know, where from this creation coming, you are taking birth, where you can go away after this, after living body, where to go, how to go, what will be my situation, Jivatma, thinking. So, you see, so, whenever anybody going to do something, you can say they have target to do this, that. But final object, final goal is there to get secure ananda. Because they are also anandamsa. They are the anandamsa of Bhagavan, anandamayana, Anandam Brahma. In Vedanta it is written, Anandam Brahma. So if Anandam Brahma directly going to specify that Ananda is Brahma, Anandam Brahma. So that Ananda is not material Ananda. Man not material Ananda. But Brahma Vastu everywhere, omnipresent, all providing Lord, Supreme Lord. So anyway, there is some Ananda. We are also Jivatma, they are also Ananda Amsa. Mamaiva Amsa, so Ananda Amsa. They also eternally want to get Ananda. But now, due to their bonded condition, their consciousness enveloped by the three modes of nature covering, that's why they cannot understand the source of enjoyment, they cannot trace out. Source of enjoyment, if they can trace out, someday, you are doing bhajan, I know, you are trying, but still today you cannot trace, you cannot 100%, you cannot feel that the source of enjoyment is Bhagavan, nothing else. If you are sure about it, then why you are running here and there to get enjoyment? Still today you are running. Because you are not sure about it. You have no feeling. So, Jiva or Anandamsa, so naturally there, you know, Anandamsa, so naturally there also get want to get Ananda eternally. Because there is no suffering in the Sarup. In the Sarup of Jiva, what Mahaprabhu wanted to show to us, that in the Sarupa of Jiva, there is no suffering, nothing. This miserable condition is, you know, created by Jiva himself, by herself. Jiva is Shakti, so herself is very nice word, you know. So nobody going to put Jivatma into trouble. They wanted to get enjoyment, but they don't know this material enjoyment can put them in trouble. The material enjoyment, each and every fraction of second, they want to secure, they want to get material enjoyment, but that material enjoyment is not all. So material enjoyment, they cannot give the eternal enjoyment. So sometime enjoyment you are getting, sometime you are crying, sometime getting some enjoyment, sometime crying, this is a fluctuation. So, Bhagavan Sri Krishna giving advice in Gita, Jehi Sangsparsaja Bhogaha Dukshajane Vati Adyantabanta Kantayo Natesu Ramate Vidaha. Jehi Sangsparsaja Bhogaha, tangible facilities. Tangible facilities mean the basic thing of enjoyment is Sabdo Sparso Rupras Gandho. Sabdo, Sabdo means sound. Sparso, touch, enjoyment, sabda sparso, roop, you know, beauty, habda sparso, roop, rasa, and gandha, smell. Those are the five basic elements of enjoyment. Any kind of enjoyment you are going to get, you expect to get, you hope, you desire, you can trace out, you can find, ultimately, there is this kind of enjoyment. Any enjoyment you like to get, then out of these five, something is there. Those five things, sabda sparsa rupa rasa, no, you are going to expect. That's why, but all material. That is why material enjoyment can never give me peace, can never give me enjoyment totally. It is, you know, for temporary enjoyment. Temporary, jehi sansparsaja bhogaha, so tangible facilities, tangible enjoyment, what you are getting in this material world, because Mayadevi is going to open one big market, very, very big market, where Mayadevi is going to sell some nice thing, and those bonded soul, they are feeling attraction, they are going to buy it, they are going to sell themselves, and they are going to buy it. Sabda Sparsha Rupa Gandha, this material world is a big market. This material world is a vast market of material enjoyment. Any enjoyment you like, you can go and enjoy. You can go to hotel, you can go to pro squatter here, anywhere you can go and get enjoyment. That's up to you. Because you are enjoying liberty, na? You are enjoying liberty. Who is going to check you? Only Shastra can check you. Only and only Sadhu Guru Vaishnava can check you. That's why Bhagavan Sri Krishna is speaking, Tasmat Shastra Pramananti Karja Karja Vyavasthito. What to do, what not to do, it is written in Shastra, so you will have to follow Shastra. Not outside Shastra. Outside people, then we have our Shastra. I already proved yesterday. You know that it is unstable, their Siddhanta, which are nothing concrete. You know. So, Shastra means actually Vedic Shastra, I am speaking. Also, more clearly, Veda, Upanishad, Puran, everything I can. All because those Veda, Upanishad, Puran ultimately going to speak about Shuddha Bhakti. Purana also speaking Shuddha Bhakti, but on. From if you go through Puran, you can get confused because there is six Sattvic Puran, six Rajasic Puran, and six Tamasic Puran. Sattvic Puran you can find the ultimate goal Vishnu, and Rajasic Puran Brahma, and Tamasic Puran you can find ultimate goal Shiva. But ultimately, if you try to understand that they speak because different kind of people are there, those who are in Rajagun, Tamagun, Satagun, so for their gradual improvement, Bhagavan arranging this way. Bhagavan arranging this way because Bhagavan wanted to ensure a gradual improvement. So those who are Rajasic, anyway, they are not going to obey me. So they will have to follow their own Sadharma. Someday they can feel, because without following Sadharma, they can never feel detachment. Let them go and do. They can get kick and kick and kick and kick. They can feel detachment, then they can. So they can go this way. Those who are tamasic, if you want to give some argument, they cannot understand. So let them follow this procedure at present. So this way, Jehi Sansparsaja Bhogaha Dukshayana, any kind of enjoyment, material enjoyment you are going to get, it's for temporary, ultimately going to give you pain. Ultimately going to put you in trouble. So it is written, Jadagre Amritapamam Pariname, Jadagre Amritapamam Pariname Bishamiva. Tat sukham rajasam sitam. That is rajasuk. You know, in the beginning you can get enjoyment, ultimately you are going to cry. Pariname bisha, it is like poison. In the starting point you can feel enjoy very nicely, but finally you can see poison is there with you. Totally poison. This way, actually, when Mahaprabhu asking Sadharma, asking Sadhu Sadhana, Pado Slok Sadhen Ninnoy, go on speaking about Sadha, Sadharma Acharani Vishnu Bhakti, that was the answer of Rai Mahasai. Now, I already discussed that all Jiva, ultimately, whatever they are doing, ultimate goal is to get enjoyment. Because Jivatma, you know, Jivatma eternally Anandamai. Only discovering there, that's why they are not feeling it. So, they are in confusion, they cannot understand the source of enjoyment. If they can trace out the source of eternal enjoyment, then there is no question of any trouble. They cannot understand the eternal source of enjoyment, that's why they are in trouble, they are running here and there. The day they can discover Finally, if they can discover, then all problem over. So, sadhana, two types of sadhana. Basically, I am not speaking of Bhagavad Dharma. Yeah, all those days I was discussing. Now, general dharma. The common people, they have no clear idea about dharma. But still, if we can divide into two groups, one group is they are only busy with panchabhautik deha, five body, mind and buddhi, intellect. Panchabhautik, five made of five elements of nature. They are always going to arrange something good. They always try to arrange something good, favorable for their body, mind and intellect. Panchabhautik, deho, mano, buddhi, to arrange their good satisfaction they are doing. First category. Second category actually, they are little bit, I no idea, clear idea, was a dharma jannu. They are actually following varnasam dharma, sadharma acharan they are doing, to their dharma. But still, why they are doing? They are doing because if I am not going to do dharma, then it is a big problem. I will have to, to suffer for that. I mean, out of fear, they are going to do. Bonded soul always busy with eliminating their troubleful experience, different kind of unauspicious thing, different kind of problem or sin, or in fear also. Hey, if you don't give water to Suryadeva, is big problem. They are out of fear there. When there is, infatuation there also, to get this way, we can find those who are, these are not natural dharma. Out of fear they are doing. Have some kind of problem they are feeling, that's why they are doing. This is not pure dharma. So, one group actually going to keep satisfied. They are actually one group. They are going to do karma. They are doing sadharma acharan. Samasta manav karma kuriteja. All men, they are doing some duty there. But I am going to make them in two groups. One busy with panchabhautik, deha, body, mind and intellect. Another group, they are dharma jannu. Dharma artha kam mokkha, this I told, for chaturvarga. This is dharma, to get dharma. So dharma, what do dharma mean? They have no clear conception of dharma. Dharma means they sing to do something good. This much they want. To do something paratha. Parathota. Dharma means that's why they are going to, donate something to somebody. They are going to give some banana to monkeys, giving some sugar powder to ants. This way giving some, they are feeding fish in a lake. This way the birds are giving some wheat and, this way. So, second group they are doing, so they want to do it for dharma. What do you mean by dharma? Dharma means parartha, to do something for others. And also I explained yesterday, actual meaning of dharma is dhri dhatu and man pratray. I already explained. By the help of which, if you can take shelter of such a thing, which can help you to cross this material ocean, is called actual dharma. The meaning of dharma is this. But material people, they don't understand. Their final goal is to reach sarga, to enjoy their unstable situation. Anyway, so their conception is to dharma. With dharma they like to do, and dharma means parartata. They like to do something good for others. For Ishwar, no clear conception of Ishvara, but still doing something. And Todiyo Vastu, sometimes they are, you know, in the name of Sanatana Dharma, they are doing Devi Puja, this, that, they are all doing. They are doing. So directly in the giving water to Surya Dev, they are Ishvara. To do something. So also when somebody going to worship Durga, Kali or Ganesh, Bhagavan speaking, they are actually worshipping me. But this is not the authentic way. This is not the authentic way. They are worshipping me. If you are going to worship, do some demigods, Bhagavan speaking, it is not authentic way. It is not the authentic way. I never advise them. But they are doing. They are Abhidhi Purvakam. It is written, Bhagavan speaking, it is Abhidhi, which is not the rules. It is, you know, totally illegal, not good. But still they are doing Abhidhi Purvakam. Abhidhi is not a rules. Abhidhi Purvakam. So they know something about Dharma, this conception. They can give water to Surya Dev. They can give some, they can feed something to Gomata. They can give some donation to Brahman. This way, they are going to give it, and they are going to do some jagya, this, that. After that, they want to get something benefit. They want to get some benefit out of that. Overall, if I discuss whole world, infinity world, whatever they are doing, it is a great jagya. But still, specifically I am speaking, whatever they are doing, with some conception of dharma, frickle conception of dharma, that they know this much, you will have to give some donation to sadhu and give some, you know, to Gomata, this, that they are doing. Because in return they are going to get something. In the first, you know, group, when I told they are busy with their body, intellect and mind, and they are going to get some enjoyment which is very, you know, material enjoyment. So, first, sadhana andhiya sajya, that is called shaddha vastu payai. First group, out of their sadhana, sadhana means the procedure of karma, they are doing something. For that, they are getting some result, but the result is nasar. Nasar means it can destroy, get destroyed. No stability of that enjoyment. First group, pasam group. Second group, where they are doing sadhana, they are searching, they don't know, but still, like a blind man, when something lost, a blind man searching something here and there, you know, putting hand, where gone, this thing. Second group, at least trying to search Nityananda. They don't know the source of Nityananda. Still, they are searching like a blind man. So for them it is written in Bhagavatam. For them it is written in Srimad Bhagavatam that Neho yat karmo dharmayo na viragayo kalpate na tirtha pado sevayai jivan upi mito hisa. He is in living condition, dead body. He in his living condition, dead body, who is not going to do anything. You know, na tirtha pada sevaya, neha, na iha yat karma. That is not at all actual karma, which is not done for dharma. Gradual, general conception of dharma. So, na iho, neho, yat karma, dharmayo, na, viragayo kalpate. That is not a real karma. It is maybe akarma, bikarma. Who can say? It is not surely karma, what is prescribed in Veda. In Veda, different, you know, prescription giving in karma. But ultimately, I already told, any kind of karma, prescription there, ultimately, they are going to sow the lotus feet of Krishna. Vedasya sarve rahamave vedya. So, in this Bhagavad sloka, we find, na iho neho Na iho mean na iho, not that. Neho yat karma dharmayo na viragayo kalpate. That is not at all karma. We cannot call it karma, which is not for the sake of dharma. And ultimately, which is not going to develop detachment, viragayo kalpate. If you are doing karma according to the prescription of Veda, but which ultimately, finally not going to develop vairagya, then what use? So, neho yat karma dharmayo, na viragayo kalpate. If that dharma is not going to, not for dharma, if that karma is not for dharma, for the sake of dharma, and that dharma, that karma not going to develop detachment, not tirthapada sevayo, what karma you are doing, and not through that karma, anyway you are not going to serve tirthapada sevayo. Tirthapada mean? Tirthapada mean Guru Vaishnava. Tirthapada mean those who are, like we say, Om Vishnupad. Tirthapad mean the whole, the total final source of all tirtha is Bhagavan Vishnu Charan. Vishnu Charan. Or Krishna Charan. Anyway, so Tirthapada mean those who are resting on the lotus feet of Guru Bhagavan. That is called Tirthapada. So it is written, if your karma is not finally going to do some seva for Tirthapada, Guru Vaishnava, anything, and not going to develop detachment in your life, not for the sake of dharma, in that case, the man going to do any karma, that then Bhagavad-ji Mahaprabhu speaking, he is a living dead body. Neho yat karmo dharmayo na viragayo kalpati na tirthapado sevayai jivan opi mrito hisa. In his living condition, he is dead body. He is dead body, he is not living man. So, karmer, what is the final, you are doing karma, na? But what is the target of your karma? Answer is for dharma. And the meaning of dharma, I already told to do something good, parartha paratha, do something for others also, parathata. Hari Guru, Vaishnav, Gomata, Brahman, to do something, a chestajana, so to do some seva for them. This swartha, swartha, swartha arthe kebal, if this swartha, swartha means swartha, you know, parartha parata, swartha parata means selfishness, nishartha parata means absence of selfishness, swartha parata means selfishness, absence of swartha parata means absence of sarthaparata, if there is there, nisharthaparata, but another word is that you never heard, that is called pararthaparata. So sarthaparata, nisharthaparata, it is there. Another thing is that pararthaparata. Pararthaparata means, you know, to do something for others, so that they can get some realization power. Pararthaparata, nisharthaparata. In the name of nishartho, in the name of self, in the name of nishartho parata, there is big banner. There is big banner in the society that we have no selfish end. We are doing this service free of cost, this, that. So there is big advertisement banner. But be sure, behind this banner, there is a great selfishness. You can find there is so much charity going on, charitable institute, this, that, big banner, we have not going to take any money, anything from anybody, any charitable institute, everything, so much. But they are going to prove that they are nishartabar, they are no selfishness. But still, those who are established in Bhagavad Dharma, those who are going to follow Bhaktivinoda Thakur and Prabhupada, they can clearly see that there is big, you know, selfishness there, dirty selfishness. in the banner, external banner is there, that we have no selfish attitude, nothing, but behind that banner, there is dirty selfishness, be sure. That is why Prabhupada used to say, you cannot believe anybody. Only you can believe Guru Vishnu. We can believe none. Only we can believe Guru Vishnu. If we believe one bonded soul, then we can get some result. So, what is the target of your karma? Is dharma. Now, dharma, you understand, parartha-parata. Parartha-parata, actual meaning is there of parartha-parata. Selfishness, sattva-parata, nishartha-parata, absence of selfishness. Another point is parartha-parata, to arrange some good for others. And parartha-parata. Parartha-parata meaning common people don't understand. Actual meaning of parartha-parata means only Gauriyamat can show this kind of parartha-parata. Because parartha-parata means to help bonded soul to increase his, you know, consciousness, and ultimately he can realize his own position, tatta, jivesarup, and after that he can get free of material bondage. That is called actually parartha-parata. So Hari, Guru, Vaishnava, Gopipro, you know, you have to try to serve them. So sartho, selfishness, you know, atyendya tipti hai. Through selfishness, you can satisfy your own sense organ and mind. This sartho, selfishness, this dharma, this word is not applicable here. This word dharma is not applicable because they are busy with their self-interest, busy with their sensual enjoyment, everything. It is one kind of kama. So, whole world dharma artha kama moksha. They are busy with this chaturbarga. Dharma artha kama moksha. Dharma, this conception I already speaking, they are busy with this. Dharma, artho, kam, moksha. After leaving this body, I can get some facility, enjoyment. So, dharma, artho, kam, mean enjoyment. Artho mean the object. The object you are getting through which you can, you know, get enjoyment. Dharma, artho, kam, moksha. Artho. Artho mean money, but in general sense, but artho means you are going to get something by the help of which you can get some enjoyment. Dharma artho kam, you can ensure your kama, common materials, material, sensual gratification you like to get. So this is dharma artho kam moksha, whole world is busy with this. Moksha means also to get rid of painful experience of this life, material life. It is also contaminated. Because they don't understand. They don't understand what is the actual meaning of moksha. So, this is not, we cannot use the dharma, this word is not applicable for them, those who are busy with sensual enjoyment. We cannot even. If the target of your karma, going to do some service for Dev, Dijo, Guru, Brahman, Vaishnava, anything, you know, Prabhupada Seva Naha, if your target is not there, if your target is not there to serve Dev, Dijo, Guru, Brahman, Vaishnava, not there, then it is called actually, you know, Take Akarmo Babikarmo Kukarmo Balaja. Akarmo Babikarmo. It can be called. It is not actually karma. The karma, actual definition of karma, you understand? In the name of karma, those who are doing some negative, it is either akarma or bikarma, but kukarma. Kukarma is bad karma. But actual target of karma, dharma. Arthat, dharma, you can remember the four leg of dharma. In Bhagavatam, In the first canto, you can find Parikshit Maharaj going to meet with one ox, Shad, and one Gomata. Gomata crying, and Shad, that ox, is one leg standing. What is the meaning? What is the inner meaning? Ox is the symptom of Dharma, and there is shortage of three legs. In general sense, the Dharma have four, leg. One is Dhan, Tapasya, Shaddhai, Vrata, everything, And there is so many. Four legs are there. If one leg only Shatta, Dhan, Tapo, so many things. So here, if Dharma, Arthat, Dhan, Tapo, Shaddhai, Vrata, Home, Japo, all different parts of your activities, karma, you are doing. If your target is Dharma, you are doing some karma, and in karma involving this Dhan, Dhan is also one kind of karma, Tapo is also, Shaddhai, Vrata, Home, Jagyarki, Japadi, all you can do with the target of Dharma. And though Dharma ultimately not going to create Vairagya, Vivek Vairagya. Vivek means consciousness. If that kind of Dharma not going to increase my consciousness, Vivek, Chetana, and not going to, create Vairagya inside my heart, or I mean to say, detachment, not going to create detachment for this material samsara, or in opposite way, I can say, not going to give me attraction for Hari, then what use of this Dharma? If I am not ultimately going to grow attraction for Hari, the eternally, Supreme Lord, then your all karma and your prachesta, you are trying to do some dharma, it is only related with your, related with your enjoyment, everything, then what use? So ultimately we see the ultimate target of karma is dharma, and ultimate dharma, that is dharma, is going to create vairagya, detachment and everything inside my consciousness can increase, and I can become busy, feel it necessary to serve, go Brahman, Vaishnava, Tirthapath, that. Those who are having Shadbuddhi, Shadbuddhi means pure buddhi, intellect. Those who are having fine intellect, Shadbuddhi, Shampanna, Bhaktigon, those who are people, those they are doing some karma, the main target is dharma. This much they understand, we'll have to do everything for dharma. Now, Mahaprabhu now asking to Raya Mahasaya, the Sadhu Sadhan Tatte, what is the sarup? I like to get definition, sarup of Sadhu Sadhan Tatte. Saddha Tattva. Saddha Tattva Sarup ki. What is the Sarup of Sadhan Tattva? Then Raimasai quoting the sloka from Vishnu Puran. It is a sloka is by Parashar Muni. Varnasramachara Varnasramacharavata Purushena Parahapamano Vishnu Raradhate Pantha nanatto tosha karanam. Varnasramacharavata. Those who are busy with varnasam dharma, perfect way. Varnasramacharavata purushena parahapmano. Vishnu aradhate pantha nanatto tosha karanam. Brahmananda starting from the beginning, grassroots level, starting. Varno evang asram. If somebody is going to follow and their target is to satisfy Supreme Lord Vishnu, Varna and Ashram Dharma, Acharan Purvak, era Param Purush, you know, they are going to satisfy that Param Purush, Hari, a Saddho, this is called Saddho Sadharma. I mean, in this case, Sadharma, if I apply this word Sadharma, that is called Varnasam Dharma, perfect Varnasam Dharma. And Varna, you know, there is Brahman, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Shudra. Ashram also, you know, four type of ashram. Brahmacharya, Garhastho, Vanaprastho or Sannyas. According to their nature and conditions, power they can follow Varna and Ashram Dharma. And you will have to follow it in toto, jathayatho. If you are going to follow Varnasam Dharma to the point, then it is Sadharma. If you are going to break rules and regulations, everything, whatever you like you do, then Sadharma, you cannot satisfy Vishnu. Sadharma means, suppose you are going to lead your Grihastha life, you are leading, and you like to satisfy Brahman, Vaishya, everything, you know. So Grihastha, Prabhupada speaking, those who are leading their Grihastha life, for them, they will have to think all good for the other jivas also. They should not do any hingsa. Prabhupada speaking, they should think about their good. Suppose you have some extra food, you will have to give to kutta, dog. You have to give some, when you cook, first of all you have to offer to Gomata. This way you will have to offer, you know. All jiva, you will have to do this way. So, varnasramacharavata, those who are going to follow varnasam dharma, for them, if their target is to satisfy Vishnu, and if they are going to follow their varnasram ashram dharma in toto, properly, then it can satisfy Supreme Lord. There is a pantha, the way. Pantha means way. There is no other way to satisfy Supreme Lord. Why is speaking Sestra Pantha? Because according to their grade, they can feel it necessary. Sestra Pantha, why speaking Sestra Pantha? It is a very nice pantha, Sestra topmost way. Because those who are leading life, their condition is, they are in such a condition, they cannot go off. For them, this kind of commitment given. That is when Shastra, this Karma Yogya is all, in another chapter, it's a Gyan Yogya is final. Why? To grow their, you know, faith. To create their faith, to grow their faith in it. They have this kind of nature, they cannot go off. If I cannot say this is up, they can break and they cannot follow, you know, sadharma nidhanam seva paradharma bhayam. Like Arjun wanted to leave all bow and arrow, everything, and wanted to lead the life of Brahman. You know, first, he is speaking to Krishna, better I can go and leave everything, I can bake and eat and lead my life. Is the dharma of Brahman. That is why Bhagavan wanted to prove that it is not your duty, you will have to do according to your nature. So now you should understand, those who are going to follow Varnasam Dharma properly according to their nature and strength, condition, you have doing in toto, they can get some facility. Facility means they can satisfy Supreme Lord. And this declaration, it is given to create faith. They can develop faith. Now, okay, it is all. Follow? Like those who are Ramanandi, Ramanuja Sadhu, for them, Ramayana is the all. Ramayana is the final. You go through Ramayana, Ramayana is all, Sarvapuri, it is all. Because if it is not written, those who are following Ramayana, those who are Ramanandi, they are having strong faith, Ram, they cannot get stability. That is why. Like this kind of stability was tested by Mahaprabhu when Muraridutta Mahaprabhu asking to Murari Gupta, you should do the bhajan of Krishna. Krishna is the full source of all rasa. Why not you do? Then Mahaprabhu wanted to see his stability. Ultimately, Mahaprabhu could realize there is strong stability. Is Mahaprabhu speaking, you are the eternal servant of Ram. So why you can change? I wanted to test you. Also, Anupam, the younger brother of Rup Sanatan, they wanted to test him. They wanted to request him, why not you do the bhajan of we three? We can all do the bhajan of Krishna, why not? He wanted to, he tried his best, but he was failure. He said it is not possible. Murari Gupta also say, I already sell my head unto the lotus feet of Raghunath. So now it is not possible for me. What to do? Now also I cannot violate your instruction, so better I like to die. Mahaprabhu was thinking, this kind of stability I wanted to see. I wanted to see in you. So to increase stability, in each Odhya you can see. Karma Yoga, Gyan Yoga, Dhyan Yoga, Rajgo Yoga, everywhere speaking Krishna. It is the final, very nice. Finally, Arjuna was bound to speak. If you think it is final, why you are giving instruction about all those things? You could speak clearly what you are, you know. But Bhagavan Sri Krishna, they don't know this way actually doing, because those according to their nature and habit, they can follow this procedure, he can follow this procedure, she can follow this procedure. So according to their nature, they can follow. This is the right procedure. Sheshe adhikari janishtaha sa gunaha parikirtita viparjastu deshoha. Viparjastu, if they break their, you know, then it is sadharma nidhanam seo paradharma bhayabha. Though it is not good, merit is not there so good, but still you will have to follow this, because you have this kind of grade. Sadharma yaratu. You cannot break and jump to follow. So, varnasramachara vataha purushena parahapaman Vishnu raradhati pantha na nattottoshakaranam. There is no other way to satisfy Vishnu. Ramananda giving this kind of argument. There is no other way. Oh, really? You know. What is the significance? You know. Significance is that ultimately to satisfy Vishnu is the Saddha Tattva, basic Saddha Tattva. What target should be there? To satisfy Vishnu as the target. Now, to satisfy Vishnu, target. Tomorrow I can show that different people doing their conception of Dharma is different. Anyway, they are following something, but some going to fear, out of fear they are doing, some out of shame they are doing, somebody compulsory will have to do this way, forcefully. But that is not actual. Finally, I can prove that when they are going to do from heart, this bhakti, it is called savai pangsam parodharma yato bhakti radhakshaje ahetuka apratiyata. This target, you should, you know, you can see this target. If you are not going to fulfill this target, then we are not going to say it is pure bhakti. So anyway, so this Rai Ramananda, starting from the basic point, there is krama marge, gradual marge, Vishnu Radha. It is good. You know, Varnama Asa, Jathayato, in toto, if they are going to follow their Varnama Asram, Karmamar, gradual mode of promotion, Vishnu Aradhana, this is the pantha, this is the only way, no other way. Really so, there is no other way. Vishnu, to satisfy Vishnu is the, you know, all different kind of rules and regulation, all everything given. Why? Ultimately, to satisfy Supreme. you should not do it, you should not do it, you should do it, we should do it this way, all rules and regulation, you know, ete vidhi nishadha, different kind of vidhi, rules and regulation, restriction, everything, all centering, going to, you know, pivot it in this point. Arthat Vishnu, to satisfy Vishnu, satisfy. It's called Shaddha Tattva. Because Sutadev Goswami speaking in Srimad Bhagavad-Gita Mahapuran, first canto, second chapter, Ataha Pumbhir Dijo Sreshta Varna Srama Vibhaga Saha Sanoshtitasya Dharmasya Sangsriddhir Haritoshanam. So first look, Rama was speaking as the Sarup of Sadharma, starting point. Sadharma, Sadharma Acharan. Shaddha Tattva, Shaddha Tattva is Sarup. So Sadharma Acharan, and Sadharma Acharan, I already told, Varnasrama Acharya Vata Purushena Paraha Pumano Vishnu Raradhati Pantha Nanatva Tosha Karanam. There is no other way. And this, you know, Parasar Muni speaking in, you know, Vishnu Puran, also Bhagavad-ji Mahapuran going to support it. Ataha Pumbhir Dijo Sreshta Varnasrama Vibhaga Saha Sanoshtitasya Dharmasya Sangsiddhir Haritoshanam. Sadharma Sakal, what you are doing in the form of Sadharma, Sadharma means it is the duty of Arjuna to fight and satisfy Krishna. It is the duty of, you know, Vidurji Maharaj to follow this procedure, satisfy. All such different kind of procedures are given. They are following their Sadharma. So Sadharma Sakal, all Sadharma, Sangsiddhi, mane total service, mane total final satisfaction. Sadharma Sangsiddhi, your Sadharma can come out successful when you are going to satisfy Hari, Haritoshan. So, Sutadev Goswami also speaking in Srimad Bhagavatam, Ataha Pumbhi, Pumbhi men, all Jivatma, whatever action they are doing, whatever they are doing, Ataha Pumbhir Dijya Sreshta Varna Asrama Vibhagasa, Varna Evang Asram, according to Varna and Asram, they are doing something, they are always trying something, Vibhagasa, Sanushchitasya Dharmasya, whatever they are doing karma, with a target of Dharma, if that target not going to satisfy Hari, then what use? So, Sanishitasya Dharmasya, Sangsiddhir, they can get success when they can satisfy Vishnu. That is why our Sutadev Goswami in Bhagavad-ji Mahapuran speaking, Ataha Pumbhir Dijo Sreshta Varnasama Vibhagasaha, Sanishitasya Dharmasya, Sangsiddhir Haritoshanam. He is speaking. But actually, after that, sanushchitasya mean, sanushchitasya mean all perfectly. Atishay sundarupe job, then everything, saddhaya, dan, brahma, all sanushchitasya mean perfectly if you are doing. But if your target is not to satisfy Supreme Lord, then what use? No use. That's why we can discuss tomorrow that Naishkarmam Opi Achyuta Bhava Varjitam. Naishkarmam Opi Achyuta Bhava Varjitam Na Sabhate Jnanam Amalam Niranjanam Kutaha Punaha Shashad Abhadram Ishware Na Charpitam Karma Jadapi Akaranam. So what I say? Naishkarmam Opi. If it is Naishkarma, no selfish end. Naishkarmam Opi Achyuta Bhava Varjitam. There is no feeling of Achyuta, Dharma, actual. And our target is not to satisfy Supreme Lord. Naishkarmam Opi Achyuta Bhava Varjitam. Na Sabhate Jnanam Amalam Niranjanam. Even pure Jnan. Jnan when? Na Sabhate Jnanam Amalam Niranjanam. Kutaha punaha shashad abhadram ishvare na charpitam karma yadapi akaranam. I can discuss this tomorrow. So now see, this varnasram palan sadda tattva nahi. Not only. Only varnasram palan, only to follow, I am following it, but the target should be to satisfy Hari. Varnasram dharma, you are following, you can say I am following, but you cannot satisfy, then no, not. Then it is your failure. So, keval, only to follow varnasram dharma is not sadda tattva. Rai Ramananda never wanted to prove this. You know, varnasram dharma, you know, only to follow varnasram dharma without the target to satisfy Krishna is not there. But when the target is to satisfy, then it is sadda tattva. So, sadda, so Rai Mahasaya, Rai Ramananda, Saddha Tattva Nirnoy, when in the way of detecting, when in the way of, you know, opening the secrecy of Dharma, Ramananda in first step wanted to speak this Sadharma, wanted to speak this Sadharma. But Mahaprabhu told, it is external thing. Because those who are going to follow some rules and regulations, everything, you know, somebody in fear, somebody in pressure. So, there can be the smell of karma gandha. When they are doing something, sadharma parihar purvak saranagato, I can come to the next point. So, Mahaprabhu speaking now at present, it is external. It is external. It is not final. So please speak. Go on speaking something more. So it is external. Mahaprabhu saying, Prabhu kahe eho bajho, baiho, Prabhu kahe eho baiho, age kaho ar. Please speak. It is Varnasam, Dharma Palan, Adi, etc., Saddha Tateja, Lakshan, all symptom, so long I am discussing, it is Gauna Lakshan, primary Lakshan, primary symptom. If you have anything, you can speak more in deep. You speak something in details, you know. Then Rai started speaking. Rai kahaye Krishne karmarpan sarva-saddhosar. Sarva-saddhosar, sadhan-mon, you want to know this sadhan-tattva, sarup of sadhan-tattva. So gradually Rai Ramananda speaking. Rai Ramananda now speaking. Rai kahaye Krishne karmarpan. If I can give everything to Krishna, Krishna karmarpan, everything, whatever I am doing, then it is actually sarva saddha sar. All dependent saddha is there, it is topmost. So, Rai kahe Krishna karmarpan, sarva saddha sar. It is the sarva saddha sar. Or saddha is final. Different kind of clesh, jatanadi deke mukti ba atmasuk, you know. Tara, whatever, Bhagavan already, I told you 3-4 days before, Bhagavan speaking in Gita, if you can give everything to me, then fruitive activities, if you are not going to do any fruitive activities, because the result mean bad. Any material karma has some bad result. So, Bhagavan speaking to Arjuna, yat karosi, yad asnasi, yad yuhosi, dadasi yat. Yat tapasosi kanteyo, tat kurusha madarpana. Whatever you are doing, you know, japa, tapasya, tapa, whatever you are, yogya, dan, whatever you do, but you do in my name. You try to offer it to me. Don't try to get the result of that. Result is contaminated. Result, any karma you are going to do, That's why I told yesterday why Narottama Thakur going to teach us that pious activity is more dangerous. Punno se sukhe dam naloyo tanna. Pious activity is dangerous because pious activities you are doing has some result. That result going to put you in danger, in bondage. So any kind of pious activities you are doing, then it is one kind of bondage. But if, when you are doing everything and all for the satisfaction of the Supreme Lord, then it is okay. That is why Bhagavan in Gita advising, giving advice to Arjuna, yat karosi, what you are doing, yat asnasi, what you are eating, what you are done, donation you are giving, whatever you are doing, yat tapasasi, what tapasya you are doing, kontiyo, he Arjuna, tat kurusha madarpanam. Don't try to get the result. Don't be busy with result. Because you have no right to think about result. Result is your bandhan. Why you are expecting result? Karmanyeva adhikaraste ma phaleshu kadachana. You have only right in karma. You should not expect any result. Then somebody can say, you are mad, Maharaj. If there is karmanyeva adhikaraste ma phaleshu kadachana, without any target fruit, who can do, Maharaj? That is a question. 3, 4, 5 days ago, I told you that those boys, they are playing. Why they are playing? What is the outcome? Any profit and loss? No. They are simply game. They let you enjoy. So this also we have to think this way. You know, if you put question, if there is no target, Maharaj, if there no benefit, no profit, why should I do anything? It is really so. Without any target, even you know, foolish people also don't like to do. Without any target. So target should be there. So what is the target that you have to find out? Otherwise in confusion. Why should I do karma? I already give example, no? Those boys playing, why? There is no profit and loss account. Only they want to enjoy. So, karmanyeva adhikaraste ma phaleshu kadachana. You should not expect any result. Automatically you can get result according to the desire of Krishna, but if you play, if you are going to play your head over, you know, this result, it is one kind of bondage. Karma, that is why, you know, you can find in Gita, if somebody having no attachment, nothing, no attachment, nothing, totally he is doing everything for Supreme Lord. Nothing. No smell of. In that case, it is written, without any akankha, desire, nothing, no self-interest, nothing. If he is going to do, if his target is the lotus feet of Krishna, if he is going to kill the whole world, still he is not going to get the result of the sinful activities. I can show you. Tomorrow I can discuss. If you have desire to do seva, but no, you have no attention to do, you have no attention to get, you know, result. That is why Bhagavan speaking, karmanyam vadhikaraste. Karmanyam vadhikaraste ma phalishu kadachana. You have no follower. Result according to the desire of Krishna you can get. And so you have to offer everything. Show those who are new, their heart is not contaminated, they are not doing anything for their selfish and nothing. So Arjun, if you are going to do your sadharma, if you are going to follow your sadharma, so if your submission is perfect, if your submission is perfect, be sure, then I am going to save you. I am going to save you. Sarva dharmanam paritya mamekam saranam bhaja. Ultimately, you will have to leave all, you know, any kind of dharma, and you will have to submit, full submit. Aham tam mokshishyami masucho. So, apparently, Krishna going to engage Arjuna in fighting. At the same time, Vishwarupa, Bhagavan Sri Krishna speaking, Arjuna, you wanted to see my Vishwarupa? you know, Vishwarup, universal my, you know, Roop, my, you see, infinity world. Then Krishna going to show to Arjuna that you have your false ego, that you don't like to kill, you don't like to fight with Pitama Visha. You don't like to fight with Dronacharya, they are respectable personality, they are guru. But you see, you have a false ego, a dualship. Who are you to fight? Who are you to fight with them? Who are you to kill them? Ultimately, Arjuna speaking, when Krishna gone from this material world, when Arjuna crying, in front of Yudhishthira Maharaj, he was bound to speak the truth. That now I realize the net outcome of Gita. Arjuna speaking, that time I was bound to speak, okay, I realize, I understand. But that time my realization was not perfect. Now when Krishna gone, I discover what kind of Nectarian teachings given by my friend Krishna. Same Arjuna, same Gandiv, bow and arrow, same chariot, everything. But where is that power? All gone. Hey Rajan, I am defeated in front of some tribal. Really? Yes, I'm defeated. Where that power gone? Same Arjuna, same chariot, same Gandiv, but I am totally failure now. Now I realize all power coming from Krishna. Who am I? Only I have false ego. False ego. I am doer. I am doing this, that. Nothing can stand. So today, I am going to realize the exact teachings, outcome of Gita. Arjuna's speaking today. Arjuna is defeated. When Krishna is speaking, who are you to kill? Who are you to fight? I am doing everything. You see, I already killed. It's there. When Vishwarup, you can follow, there you can find Pitama Visha already die. Dronacharya already. Karna already. Oh, really? You know, Dashanantareshu Tit. Within the gapping of truth, there is actually the Vishwarup. There is Pitama Visha hanging. You know, Dronacharya, Karna. Oh, really? Arjuna watching. Who are you to kill? I am doing everything. You are only traveling infinity world because of his dualship. This is the only problem. Still today you cannot diagnose your disease, symptom. The only problem, the only disease with you, the only disease that is dualship. Me and mine. If this dualship gone, 100% submission, all and any action done by you, you need not play your head over that virtue or vice. Because it's the responsibility of Krishna. Krishna already speaking, the aham tam moksha ishami masucho. It is my responsibility to save you. And also we can know one sloka that mannimitta kritam papam dharmaya kalpate. If you are doing for me, mannimitta kritam papam dharmaya kalpate. What is dharma? What is adharma? All rubbish conception. Krishna speaking, when somebody doing something for me, that is dharma. If you are doing all pious activities, but there is no target of Krishna, what use? Krishna says it is also adharma. If there is no target, you know. Yeah. So you see, Bhagavan Sri Krishna speaking, that mannimitta kritam papam. When Sudama Vipro, Krishna giving advice, I am very feeling hungry. You can go and fried grain there. You can get something. Oh, no, Guru Ma, the Guru Ma and the mother. I mean ashram mother. I mean the wife of Guru. Can watch, arrest me? No, 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 no. She is not there. You can go. I'm very hungry. Could you please do it? You love me, no? Yes, I love you. Go. And when going to steal, then Krishna speaking to Guru Ma, you see, he is stealing. Then he was arrested, Sudama, and he is crying. After that, anyway, in front of Krishna, he is speaking, I am stealing for you. Why you speak? And I was testing that what you can do for me. What you can do for, what not you can do for me. What you can do for me and what you can, what not you cannot, what not you can do for me. I wanted to test. Oh, really? So, if Sudama stealing from Krishna, for Krishna, it is also good. You can remember, Srila Bhakti Vigyan Bharati Maharaj also used to give this, I also give this example. Alwar, in South India, that Alwar, I forget his name, I speak, that Alwar, he discovered that Ranganatham in the forest. Tiruppan Allar, I remember. Tiruppan Allar. Tiruppan Alwar, he discovered, you know, Ranganatham in forest, dense forest. Oh my God, is Prabhu here? Yes, from Sattaju, Ranganatham was there. Now, what to do? Then Tiruppanallar, Bhagavan came in dream and speaking, you will have to make one big temple for me and start seva, this, that, so much. Tiruppanallar saying, I am a beggar, penniless, what to do? You will have to do somehow, I don't know, you have to do. Because with instruction, when Guru Vaishnava giving instruction, you will have to do it. If you feel, what to do, how I can do, I am very... You should remember, with the instruction of Guruji, Guru Vaishnava, there is power translated inside you. But you will have to feel it. You will have to feel it. When Guru Bhargava, pure Sadguru, going to give you instruction. With the instruction is translating power. Prabhupada giving instruction to Bhagavan Goswami, you must go and preach the teachings of Chaitanya, Chaitanya Vani, to Bhakti Padipitita Maharaj, to Bhana Maharaj, to Gosai Maharaj. But be sure, they are getting power from Prabhupada. So this way we will have to feel. When Ranganatham going to give instruction, you will have to arrange one big temple for me. Then, same thing, when Panchatattva and Guru Varga came directly in Yogapit in front of Prabhupada when he is busy with 1 crore Nam Jagya. Well, how I can do? You will have to preach. How I can do? It's a question of big money, big amount of money and manpower, Be sure. If it is the desire of Nityananda, be sure 100% I am sitting in Vyasasana. You will have to feel it. If by the desire of Gurudev, Guru Varga, Prabhupada, Bhaktivinoda, if I am speaking Harikatha, believe me, I am not going to spend even a single penny for preaching. If somehow this preaching is done by Nityananda, it is his responsibility. I am idiot number one, foolish. I am only speaking, sometimes I feel inspiration more because today actually internet problem, I break, you know, because one stream of flow of thoughts coming. In between I cannot tolerate this, you know, I feel disgusted. I can tolerate everything. By the time of Harikatha I cannot feel this kind of disturbance. It's impossible for me. My heart breakdown, big problem. So Ranganatham. You know, I am speaking, and I am speaking about Prabhupada, you know. Prabhupada said, how I can do? Everything is behind you. Everything coming. Don't think. Then Prabhupada, you know, really so. All his eternal parshads and all sevak, everything, all money, position, you know, temples, all foreign preaching, everything done by Prabhupada. You know, should remember. There was not even one pot. You know, there was no pot. In my life also. I am sitting in Vyasasam, if I am speaking lie, I can die. When I come from Vrindavan, almost penniless. I have no utensil. When I sit, one man make one very small place. Very small place, one very small, no electricity, nothing. But I am thinking there is no how I can cook rice. Then some old lady, you know, the disciple of someone goes and give some pot. I walk. After that I give something. After that I give something. This way, up to now, how and why, which way I am doing, I don't know. There is the arrangement, all the arrangement of Supreme Lord. All the arrangement of Supreme Lord, I don't know how, you know. So with the instruction, when Santa Goswami was speaking, you know, when Satya Govinda Maharaj speaking, Bhakti Vallabha Tirtha Goswami Maharaj speaking, Bharati Maharaj speaking, you know, Bonu Baba speaking, all, you know, Bhakti Vardhan Sagar Maharaj speaking, you know, Nayanananda Baba speaking, all other many Goswami. You will have to speak Harikatha. And why? One day I was, you know, after darshan of a Chatak Parvat in Puri, Guru Maharaj was that time in Puri. You know, no. That time Guru Maharaj was not there. Guru Maharaj went there later. No. That time, I cannot remember. That time, me and one devotee, you know, we two going to take darshan of Totakapina, everything, in walking. Because they have no money to take one toto. No, walking. Still today I can walk 40 kilometers very easily by the desire. Sometimes I, you know, feel sick. Some reason can be there. So this way, I go and Chatak Parva, it was almost evening time. I take darshan of everything. After the Chatak Parva, I pray Dandavat to the Bhajan Kutir of Prabhupada, everything. Then I come down. Almost down, out of gate. Then one devotee, his name is Bon Baba. You know, I can say he is Siddha Mahatma. He is a disciple of Goswami Maharaj. Very nice. He is doing Nam Jagga there. I don't know why. He running outside with one garland of Prabhupada. Outside. How he realized he give this garland to my... You know, offered to me, and speaking, you must speak Harikatha. What is this? When I was there with him, when I already there in the top hill of that, you know, Chatak Parvat, then he already saw me, then not speaking anything. Why now he is running? I was surprised. Now I realize, I am stupid number one, I am foolish, I am penniless, anyway, but still, maybe it is a desire of Nityananda. Preaching can only be done by the desire of Nityananda. Preaching can only be done by the desire of Nityananda. But is the authority of preaching. Is the authority of preaching. You know. Is the authority of preaching. So, you should realize this point. Now I am going back to this man. Why Bhagavan speaking man nimitta kritam papam dharmaya kalpate? For me, if you do anything, apparently everybody can say it's sinful, but still it is not sinful. It is good. Why? Tirupanallar finally coming out of the forest and begging here, going, taking trouble to go here and there, beg for money here and there. Nobody going to give him money. You give me. Bhagavan, I like to make one big temple of Supreme Lord, you know. He is there in the forest. Hey, go away. Nobody giving. Somebody giving something which is not sufficient. Finally, what is, you know, now Tiruppanallar took decision what to do. They are going to waste money. They are going to enjoy in every, you know. They are going to waste their money like water for enjoyment. I was surprised to get one information. How it is possible for a Arabian set, he is spending, I forget the amount of money, this crore of money he is spending within one night. I was surprised. One night? What is eating? What he is doing? Eh? What he is doing? So much amount? I got right information. It is source. From internet, somebody saw me, Maharaj, he spent this set, spending this crore of rupees. One night? I said, gone mad? Eh? One night? Really so? Then Tiruppanalla thinking, for Supreme Lord, I am ready to do anything. For Supreme Lord, I am ready to do anything, like Hanumanji Maharaj. Hanumanji Maharaj tried to understand. Hanumanji Maharaj, when he was asked by some devotee, some demigods, or I forget the name, he is asking, you have done so sinful activities, you are setting fire whole Lanka, you burn up. Hanumanji Maharaj, I have done nothing. But you have done. Because Ravan set fire on his tail with, inflammable objects, ghee, everything, and, tied. And Hanumanji Maharaj, when they are applying fire in the tail, Hanumanji Maharaj laughing. I said, why is he laughing? He is going to die. Hanumanji Maharaj said, now it is the point. Hanumanji Maharaj started jumping from this roof to that roof and setting fire to everything. Whole Lanka burn up. Now Hanumanji Maharaj was asked, you burn up everything, whole Lanka, so Jivatma, you kill? Hanumanji Maharaj, I have done nothing. You have done nothing? But no, I have done nothing. Nothing. No wrong. All done by Ramji. I am not responsible, I have done all for Ramji, so I am not going to take any bad result of that activities. It is not at all sinful activities. I have done all I have done for Ram. So, I am not going to take any responsibility. Similar way, Tiruppanalla thinking this point, maybe he is thinking about Hanumanji Maharaj. Oh, Hanumanji Maharaj. So I can see what I can do. Then after that, he is going to make disciple. Three or four disciples, I forget. One disciple, he can walk over water. Another disciple who can touch any lock, he can get open. Lock. I heard from some devotee, that our Baman Goswami Maharaj also had this kind of tactics. I was laughing. Some Jagannath Prabhu, he is staying in Chittaranjan. He used to love me very much. He is old man, railway 7. He told Maharaj, one day I was not in home. I have gone outside. Guru Maharaj came without any. That time no hello, bolo. This kind of phone facility was not there. Baman Goswami Maharaj went there because some seva was there. But the room was closed. Baman Goswami, but the Jagannath Prabhu when come, he find the Gurudev is already sitting inside room. Home is open. Why Gurudev? Why I open the lock? How you open? Well, I can give answer to you. Foolish. I can give answer to you. Baman Goswami Maharaj. Is to magic. No, some mantra by which I open the lock. But they can also open the lock of our heart, which is blocked up. Yes, Guru Vaishnava can do everything. So, that disciple can open the lock. And another disciple, that disciple has that kind of capacity, if he is going to put his leg on his saddle, if he is going to put his leg on your saddle, you cannot move even 1 inch. Even 1 inch you cannot move. That kind of power, shadow. Then he engage everybody. And after that, engage everybody. So you try to understand, I don't want something deep. You can feel it from heart. What is bhakti? How much dedication should be there? You should be ready to give your life itself. for Supreme Lord. That is the final decision. And if it is bhakti. So finally, they are going to loot. Loot means they are going to, you know, snatch money here and there, everything, you know. They are going to break the locker and get money and ornament, everything. They gather everything. And after that, Ranganathan temple, you know, under construction. Big temple. I never went there because I have no time. Very nice temple. You know, at present, how much money you can spend. But still, whatever amount of money, you cannot make that kind of temple. I heard. I never been there. After that, finally those, you know, set, those rich people, they make one group. At present, university and, you know, suburban area, that this kind of, you know, group is there who is going to break our locker, everything. We can mess one group and give them punishment. We must go. You know, they make one group. They finally reach, you know, somehow they reach that Tiruppanallur. You will have to give back our money, ornament, everything what you have taken. Well, I can give, but it is not with me. Where it is? You will have to give. And we can kill you. If you kill me, you cannot get money. Oh, I am not. Anyway, we are not going to kill you. But if you don't give, then we can kill. But I am going to speak you the truth that it is there. Inside that, you know, river, you can go. Inside the river? Yes. Because it's a valuable thing. I keep underwater, 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 I keep. I can give you, but if you go there, then that devotee who can walk over water, they arrange one boat, which is useless boat, is going to break down in the midway, then that Tiruppanallur give order and giving indication, gesture, you can do, go, give them there. Then that disciple going in the midwater. After that, he arranged the boat to break down. They don't know swimming, everything. All the group of the set rich men, they die spot in water, in the spot. And that disciple, walking over the water, and they come to Gurudev. Gurudev, seva done nicely. Gurudev is smiling and speaking, okay, nice. We have done it for Ranganatham. We have done it for Ranganatham, not for myself. Nice seva done. Now, go on doing seva. So you see, try to understand the mood of a devotee. So now, tomorrow I can explain what is karmarpan, and if karmarpan, this mood is not pure, what contamination can be there, possible contamination, and what can, you know, then Mahaprabhu can speak again. This is not final. It is external. You can go. You can go again. You can speak. Now, final, I like to hear. Then Mahaprabhu can speak again. This way, we can go on discussing about this, you know, Raya Ramananda Sangbad. This way, we can go on discussing about, but first, step by step, all. Today, I was feeling some disturbance in the beginning. I was not feeling easy. So anyway, somehow I complete, and today, tomorrow I can go on discussing about why Mahaprabhu not satisfied. What can be possible, you know, contamination in karmarpan if it is not pure. So aham apitartha karana nishinisayana nana manuratha dhiya khana bhagana nidra दैव अहतार्थ रचना ऋषयो योपि देवा युष्मात् प्रसंग विमुखा इह संसरन्ति युष्मात् प्रसंग विमुखा इह संसरन्ति वांछकल्पदुर्वस्य के पासिन्द व्यवच पतितानं पावन भवैष्णवभ्यो नमो नमः।